All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios. And welcome back in studio, Jim Bannantine, the CEO of Great Panther Silver. And Jim, great to see you. How you doing?
Good, Steve. It's nice to be here.
So last time you were here, we were talking about this acquisition of Beadell that Great Panther was doing. And so just give everyone a quick sort of refresher on this deal.
Sure. So remember, this deal brought Great Panther's balance sheet of $55 million in cash and no debt to Beadell's asset of Tucano, which is a very large asset, gold-producing asset, that had some debt on it. So you put our Great Panther's balance sheet with Beadell's asset, you get a 200,000-ounce gold equivalent producer, 50,000 from Great Panther and 150 from Beadell, and takes us to an intermediate level, a new intermediate gold producer.
And there were a lot of companies, a lot of people who look at the sector coming out and saying how important this deal was and how good of a deal it was. So it had to go to a shareholder vote. So give us the results of the shareholder vote from both sides, yours and Beadell.
Yeah. So I guess the real news of today is that we got shareholder approval on Monday in Vancouver and on Tuesday in Perth, Australia, for both sets of shareholders, the Great Panther shareholders in Vancouver here at the Terminal City Club, and in Perth. Both sets of shareholders voted over 96% in favor of the deal. So we've been talking about the logic of the deal, of being a good deal. Well, other people agree with us.
Yeah. And what does that say to you when you saw that you knew in your heart that this was the right thing to do, and then you see your shareholders are backing you? That's got to make you feel pretty good.
It makes us feel really good. It's not only really good, but it truly is a historic day for Great Panther.
Yeah. Let's talk about, you've also released your guidance, so tell us a bit about that.
Sure. So when we talked last time, that was going to be coming out in a few days. So Beadell and Great Panther, prior to the shareholder vote, and we haven't closed yet, we'll close, that's a good point, we'll close in the 5th of March.
Okay.
So the shareholder approval leads to a court hearing, which leads to a share exchange. That'll happen on the 5th of March. But we both published our guidance, so we're still two companies for another couple of weeks. The Great Panther guidance is 3.7 to 4 million ounces of silver equivalent ounces at an all-in sustaining cost of about $10.50 without corporate G&A and about $13.50 to $14 with corporate G&A. The Beadell guidance is 145 to 155,000 ounces of gold equivalent, which is all gold in Beadell's case, at an all-in sustaining cost of $1,000 to $1,100 per gold ounce.
Wow, so good numbers.
So the 4 million ounces of Great Panther silver equivalent is equivalent to 50,000 ounces of gold at an 80-to-1 exchange ratio. So you're talking about 50,000 ounces coming from Great Panther, 150,000 ounces coming from Beadell. So we're talking about the combined company producing 200,000 ounces of gold this year at roughly $1,000 to $1,100 all in sustaining costs.
Wow. So that leads now to, as you mentioned, the deal will close on March the 5th. So how does the future look now? What is the next steps for these two companies combined?
Well, the first step in the future is to operate and to operate well.
Yeah.
So you've got two operating companies operating three producing mines in two different countries. So we will operate those this year. Making 200,000 ounces, which is quite a considerable quantity, puts us in that intermediate range.
Yeah.
We've also got, if you recall from the last discussion we had, we've got almost 6 million ounces of gold equivalent resources. Of that 6 million ounces, a little less than 1.5 million ounces is reserves.
Okay.
So that 1.4 million ounces of gold yields about a 7-year mine life for the Tucano asset.
Okay.
Around that is 3 million more of measured and indicated resources and another million of inferred resources. So very important next step for us at Tucano is to drill. So we will be exploring and drilling to convert those resources into reserves and extend the mine life and increase the value of the Tucano asset. On the Great Panther side, you may remember that we have the Coricancha project in Peru.
Right.
So we'll announce the final results of our bulk sample program next month in March and take a decision on restarting Coricancha, which would add another little over 3 million ounces of silver or 50,000 ounces more of gold to our production for the future.
And when you just real quick on the drilling, will that happen this year?
We'll start drilling immediately.
Okay.
And we'll start having some results late this year, probably the fourth quarter.
Well, we look forward to sharing the news.
Thanks.
Congratulations
a lot.
On everything.
Great to be here,
sounds
Steve.
Like
it's a
good
match
day. Made in heaven, eh?
Thanks a lot.
All right, that's Jim Bannantine, the CEO of Great Panther Silver, talking about this new deal that's now shareholder approved with Beadell.